What to do, where to go, what's happening and when. The spotlight's on fun and excitement all this week from the Lehigh Valley and beyond. So check out your calendar and let's go.
Hi folks, Grover Silcox here. You know what time it is. Time for Let's Go. On this episode, we take you to Berks County and an old workshop where wheelwrights and wagon makers plied their trades. We'll enjoy breakfast at a cozy little diner in the heart of Hatboro. But first, our intrepid reporter, Tracy Yatsko, goes on a wild whirlwind flight of derring do in King of Prussia. Be careful, Tracy. Oh.
iFLY is a premier indoor skydiving facility that has taken the dream of flight and delivered it as a reality. What they were able to do is take four huge turbine engines in the top of the building to push air out, down the sides, and underneath, back up through the middle to create a closed loop circuit for a smooth wall-to-wall cushion of air for participants to fly on.
I've never done anything like this, and I have no idea what to expect. I started with the check-in process, and if I'm being honest, my nerves were on another level. Then I proceeded to the flight deck to watch the instructors do incredible tricks until my training class.
All right, so my name's Cody. I'm gonna be your flight instructor. If you're afraid to hop out of a plane, this is way more fun. In my opinion, you're in there triple the time almost. All the hand signals are right here on the wall. If you're nice and still, the wind's actually gonna lift you up, do all the work for you. And straight legs is key. As long as your legs are nice and straight, chin's up and you're looking forward, you'll have a blast today.
I'm ready.
Okay, so when I said earlier that my nerves kicked in, I'm absolutely terrified at this moment. I'm locked in, ready to go, with a smile on my face. I may have been scared, but this experience is exhilarating. I'm actually flying.
Flying in general is super unnatural, and we make that happen. It's a dream. We make it come true all the time.
And I highly recommend keeping your mouth closed, drooling purposes.
Once their flying is completed, the instructors put on an air show performance where they do the flips and tricks and all the crazy cool kind of stuff that you'd want to learn. We can fly everybody. We fly ages 3 and up with a maximum weight of 300 pounds. We are right outside of the King of Prussia Mall on Goddard Boulevard.
That's right. Cody gave me an A+.
iFLY does more than just fly. We are a one-stop shop depending on what you want to do. We host team building events to a birthday party with beverages and cupcakes and sodas and things of that nature. It is absolutely the most amazing thing you'll ever do in your life. Whether you have a bucket list experience where you want to jump out of a plane, you just want to have a fun group outing, something unlike anything you've done before, or if you decide you want to go skydiving and just want some practice as well.
One day, I'll be on his level.
As you motor south on Main Street through Hatboro, check to the left. There it is, a stainless steel beauty called Daddypops Diner. Daddypops serves lots of down-home food and plenty of hometown atmosphere.
What shall we have today?
Oh, that looks delicious.
The essence of a diner is the food. Daddypops Diner is a throwback to good old American food. It's home cooked like mom used to make.
The most important part of being a real diner is this thing. You gotta have a counter.
This was put here in 1953.
You look at that building and you know you're gonna get something to eat. They're all unique because they're typically owned by individuals and they're not part of a chain. It's an opportunity for those owners to put their own stamp on it.
The greens and the wood trims all lend into warmth and a feeling of home. It's the hometown business. We have customers that come in every day. We have a cup wall out there that has their individual cups on them that people bring in. We serve them their cup when they come in and sit down. It's taken off. I have almost 150 cups up there. Breakfast and lunch is a lot faster than dinner cooking. We do a lot of home fries. We don't put anything in them. We go through around 1,200 or 1,400 pounds of potatoes a week. Our flapjacks are our own recipe. We go through a lot of flapjacks. French toast is very popular. Scrapple. They use it all kinds of ways. It's ketchup. They put syrup on it. They have butter on it. Deep fried. They have it split and grilled. They have it in sandwiches. They have it in omelets. Outside of this area, unless you've been here, you don't know what scrapple is.
The owners are usually around if they're not at the grill themselves.
I have several years under my belt as being there. I don't do it any longer. I have good cooks. Maurice and Charles have been with me for a while. They have all the talent that's necessary. My servers are, they're my whole front line.
Enjoy.
They know what they're doing, and they have to keep all our clientele served and happy and running for their day.
More coffee?
Sure.
It is a warm, friendly place to go.
People come in because they want to spend a little bit of time away from the rest of the hustle and bustle and enjoy their meal.
Mmm, delicious.
You feel like family here, you get a great meal, you don't pay a lot of money, and you're in a clean, interesting, always kind of changing atmosphere. You'll always get very personal service and a good experience.
Welcome aboard, folks. This is your captain. We're about to take off for the Wings of Freedom Aviation Museum on the old Willow Grove Naval Air Base in Horsham.
Wings of Freedom Aviation Museum is our opportunity to preserve the history of aviation, both local and globally. So this property sits on what used to be the Willow Grove Naval Air Station. There's an incredible amount of history in our little acreage here. Over my shoulder is the Pitcairn Mail Wing, the P8 model to be precise, built by Harold Pitcairn specifically as a mail carrier. This plane can carry 1,000 pounds of mail. To make it quick to repair and give it a fast turnaround, if you look down where the U is in US mail and then go back towards the engine, you'll see a zipper. The idea behind that zipper was that if there was any problem with the flight controls and the cables, they could be accessed there without dismantling the whole aircraft. The Panther. What makes our Panther really, really unique is the name of the Marine Aviator who flew it. He did his training here before going off and serving in Korea. He sometimes played baseball. His name was Captain Ted Williams. The helicopter is the star of every episode of MASH in opening and closing sequences. An incredible, incredible restoration and probably one of the most pristine examples of its kind. The Jeep is unique. It gives us an added attraction to bring the people in, and it's proving to be very, very popular. We have wonderful trust with our visitors. Many of them have given us or loaned us their medals. We have them on display, and it's amazing how the public not only want to look at them, but they want to learn the history behind them. We have uniforms where people have donated us their flying suits, their flying equipment. They're absolutely genuine artifacts. Visitors look at our A-10 Warthog, and the guy who flew it over Iraq, who's giving them the tour of the aircraft. People will say, I enjoyed the aircraft, I learned so much, but I got to talk to a guy who flew it. Our job is to put everything we've restored and gathered on display and offer it to the public as an education, to adults and to children, anybody who wants to learn.
Easton's Nurture Nature Center is a hidden gem. It features an array of science and art exhibits, including Science on a Sphere, a globe which shows diverse phenomena such as transportation, climate change, hurricanes, and much more.
Nurture Nature Center is a science-based community center. We use science, art, and dialogue programs to help the community understand and care for the local environment. We also have science speakers and lectures and presentations here, and we also do a lot of youth and family activities.
The Science on a Sphere is one of our central exhibits. It's a large room-sized globe that's suspended from the ceiling. It's about 6 foot in diameter, and we can show over 500 different visualizations, everything from the planets to wind and precipitation. This is the iconic image of our Earth from space. You can see the blues of the ocean and then clouds in white, as well as snow and ice at the south and north poles. We have access to over 500 different data sets available from NASA. We can pull up anything from hurricanes to different planets, and then you can manipulate it using this touchpad. Dataset is the air traffic dataset. You can see each of those little yellow lines is a flight. This is about 87,000 flights in a day. This data set is showing Hurricane Harvey from space. So you can see the reds are actually showing the precipitation associated with the hurricane. The sandbox is another really fun exhibit that we have. It's an augmented reality sandbox. So you can see as I move the sand around, the colors automatically update to show the different elevations. This is great for teaching about landscapes and reading maps and watershed science.
We have an art gallery and art space here. We have rotating exhibits that come in. Currently, right now, we're showing a new exhibit in this room by Patricia Griffin, who's a regional artist. The show is called Existence, and it's about conservation for animals and species around the planet. And it's really breathtaking, very large-scale works of animals we don't frequently get to see, but that the artist was able to capture on her travels and bring back to us in beautiful paintings. Nurture Nature Center is absolutely for everyone. We have programming here for all ages. We're also a field trip destination for schools and also for businesses and organizations that want to come. I've had many people tell me that every community needs a Nurture Nature Center because it's a constant reminder of the need for the entire community to come together and care for the local environment.
If you ever watched an old Western and wondered where did they make the buckboards and wagons, wonder no more. We're going to take you to the Gruber Wagon Works at the Berks County Heritage Center.
The Berks County Heritage Center is a historic site within the Berks County Parks and Recreation System. This park itself features the Gruber Wagon Works and the Heister Canal Center. The purpose of the site is to tell our early transportation history and to share that with the public so that they can learn a little bit about what was going on in the Industrial Revolution time. This property was a dairy farm until 1976, at the time that the county then acquired part of this farm property. At the same time, what was happening was the Army Corps of Engineers was building Blue Marsh Lake. Thankfully, and very fortunately, the Wagon Works was chosen to be saved because of all the tools and equipment that were here. It was listed on the National Register of Historic Places and ultimately became a National Historic Landmark. When you come in through the doors, you're seeing the shop as it existed approximately 1915. All the tools and equipment are here that the Gruber family had to build farm wagons. There's over 19,000 objects still in the building. This is a Gruber box wagon. They also made hay flats and heavy work sleds and wheelbarrows. But this is a typical kind of wagon that would be used to carry products back and forth to town, milk cans, produce. They made three different sizes of these box wagons. They always had a seat on them. And all the fancy design work and pinstriping you see on it is typical of how they were always decorated. We're here in the blacksmith shop where George Gruber was the blacksmith until 1935 when he retired. Most of the tools that are in here are things that George created to use in doing all the ironing of the wagons. Well, this is the West tire setter, one of the last pieces of equipment that the Grubers bought to work on the wheels for the wagons. What it does is it squeezes a cold iron onto the wooden wheel. It's a hydraulic machine. It pumps oil up through the pistons to where these all press in on these pieces, which are called shoes. There are different size shoes for the different size wheels, but what is just amazing about it is that it is squeezing this cold, half-inch thick piece of iron onto this wooden wheel. Here in the bench shop, there are four benches for the wheelwrights to work. At this bench, we have a set up to show you how the spokes were carved by hand. So they're put on a vise like this. Then they used a draw knife to cut and shape them and start to make the spoke shape. Then there's a little tool called a spoke shave that it was used to do the fine work and to smooth this down, to have it come out and look like a nice spoke. Maybe not as nice as this. This one's been sanded, but that's how they started making them by hand. The C. Howard Heaster Canal Center is dedicated to Howard Heaster, whose family owned the Reading Boat Works, and it will tell the story of the Union Canal and the Schuylkill navigation systems in Berks County. Howard had always been interested and involved in helping his grandfather and his father work at the boat works. He became the local canal expert. He started to collect papers, documents, tools, other equipment. He collected over 1,400 artifacts that had to do primarily with the Schuylkill navigation system. We're very fortunate that we have Wirtz's covered bridge here in the park. It's one of only five covered bridges that remain in Berks County. It is the longest single-span bridge in the state of Pennsylvania. It stretches about 218 feet across the Tulpehocken Creek. The Tulpehocken Creek runs through our park here. The Union Canal Bicycle and Walking Trail follows along the creek, where year-round you can come and run and bike and hike and utilize the trail and just get out and enjoy nature.
The Da Vinci Science Center in Allentown is having an event this weekend on how healthcare can save lives in the Lehigh Valley. Families can meet healthcare professionals, learn how the body works, practice CPR technique, and much, much more.
This weekend is our Healthcare Career Exploration Day. So this Thursday, Friday, and Saturday will all be about learning about your body and different ways that you can keep it healthy. My name is Tyler Groffs. I am the Museum Education Manager here at Da Vinci Science Center, and it is my job to make sure that you and your family have the very best day out with kids while having fun with science. If you visit this weekend, there will be a whole bunch of different exhibitors that will all be here. All throughout this day, we might be able to actually explore different things, so like our cardiovascular system, we actually have a real heart here. Does this look like it might be a human heart?
I want to say no.
You want to say no? That is absolutely correct. Unfortunately, we really, really can't obtain human parts. It's a little bit difficult. So a lot of our things, we try to get the ones that are the most similar to human parts.
Okay.
So you can kind of learn a lot of things from whether we have hearts that are preserved. This would be something that you could potentially dissect.
Okay.
Or something that we can even feel. My friend Tiff here is actually has a set of pig lungs here for us.
And I can touch it?
Yeah, we can totally get in there and touch it.
Oh my gosh.
How's that feel?
It feels like meat.
Feels like meat,
like
absolutely.
Steak.
Like it feels like a steak. It's a very tender steak. It's always really puffy, especially as we inflate them full of air. We are looking at a cow's eye, which he can pull apart for us. We can see some of the various parts. here we have our friend Cindy Sindaver.
Cindy.
So she has all the right parts in all right places.
Cindy is not real.
She is not real.
Okay.
She is made of a saltwater hydrogel mix, which is super scientific. But she does have all of the right organs that are all kind of organized correctly, where we can actually pull apart or pull out her intestines. You can get in here with me. It's completely fine.
Looks like sausage.
It does look quite a bit like sausage.
Oh my gosh. Am I packing her right?
Yeah, kinda. They just all squished back in then.
Okay. I've watched a lot of Grey's Anatomy.
Oh, that's perfect then. Then you are just as ready. We actually start at 10 a.m. on Friday and run through to about 2 p.m. where we'll have different career exploration experts downstairs. Then on Saturday, we'll actually do the exact same thing. So we'll have from 10 to 2, we'll have experts here to be able to answer your questions and let you know a little bit more about what it's like to be a healthcare professional. And then, you know, different activities will go on all day long.
Have you recently gone on a family trip in or around the Greater Lehigh Valley? Have you found a hidden gem for a date night or a new location to spend the afternoon? Do you have photos or videos? Well, Let's Go wants to hear from you. Share your videos and or photos, and we may feature them in a future episode. Visit WLVT.org for more information.
Wildlands Conservancy in Emmaus, Pennsylvania protects and restores natural areas. It also helps teach future generations about how to sustain the environment. Its You and Me program brings together children and their grown-ups to explore nature through art, stories, and animals.
Wildlands Conservancy is a nonprofit land trust. We focus on environmental stewardship, education, and conservation.
You might see some moss, I see some green leaves.
Part of my job is to oversee school and community-based programming. So I'm designing experiences that get students and families outdoors, enjoying nature, and hopefully helping us protect it. You and Me is a program designed for children aged 3 to 5 and their grown-ups. So together, teams experience the wonders of nature in a safe, supportive environment. The theme of each program varies month by month. During last month's Frozen program, we took teams on a nature walk where we followed the wildlife tracks left by a deer. We made sun catchers with materials taken right here from Poole Wildlife Sanctuary. This animal is named Bramble II. She's one of our many education animals that we use to teach the audience about backyard wildlife, conservation, and sometimes just general animal care. What people are surprised to learn about these lizards is just how friendly they can be with people. These animals often debut during our You and Me programs, where we combine them with a storybook and a related activity. Our naturalist read The Mitten, which is a classic winter tale about animals that squeeze themselves into one mitten before it bursts. Actually introduced a screech owl, which is a small owl native to Pennsylvania that children don't get the opportunity to see up close, and we were able to provide that. Families should come to You and Me if they are nature lovers or if they're curious to know more about nature and how they can enjoy that experience with their child. Finding that magic in turning over a rock, climbing a tree, seeing an animal up close, those are the magic moments that we're trying to create and help parents utilize in their own backyard with their own families.
Thanks for joining us on this episode. Join us next week when we'll have more fun and surprises for you on Let's Go.